extension of the Malachi Act in the name of Romanity or in the name of Orthodoxy. De ce Popoveanu a dorit să revendice Banatul în numele politicii sale externe de extensie teritorială, așa cum a făcuse Mihai Viteazul, de exemplu, mai devreme cu 60-70 de ani, în numele românicății sau în numele ortodoxiei? E o întrebare care mi-ar plăcea să răspundeți, mai cu seamă că, într-adevăr, e fascinantă perioada asta și relația e una permanentă, evident, și ortodoxia mi s-a părut că joacă aici un rol fundamental în circulație. Noi știm circulația cărților, și circulația cărților ortodoxe care vin dinspre Valahia, inclusiv în spațiul silvestre, vorbitor de sână. Asta e pentru dumneavoastră și să răspundeți. Now I like to put a question for Boris Stoikovsky, who described very well the situation under the Ottoman rule, the domination of the Ottomans in the Banat area. First of all, I'd like to ask you if it's possible to talk about Banat before 1700. To use this name, or to, what kind of name is possible if it's not possible the Banat name to use? In which modality is it possible to define the region? I have another question. Probably when you define the words between Ottomans, Romanians, Serbs and Hungarians, but much more between Ottomans and Hungarians, in which modality you define the identity, so-called national identity? We don't talk in the same language. We talk a lot with Javier Fernandez Sebastian about the language. It's another history in 16th century than in 7th, than in 18th century or in 19th century. In which modality you define the terms Valachian, Hungarians, Ottomans, because it's very important for us as a people very close to the conceptual history and to the concepts to define the vocabulary, the social political vocabulary in 16th century or in 17th century, exactly under the Ottoman rule, about what we discuss finally. Okay, and that is the question for you, Boris. For Boris. And finally, Sorin Antopi introduced a lot of issues here, especially the problem of words inside of the region. We have also the different time strata. It's a time of historicity. We don't say it's the same history in the Banat region, in this case, in 16th century and in 18th century and in 19th or 20th century. We have different histories here. It's not only continuity, it's also discontinuity in many respects. And for this reason, for example, and I cannot agree with the permanent wars between, because it's the convenient, it's the region on the border. It's not continue wars here. After, for example, after 1700s, because it's this example in our discussion nowadays, after 1700, the Habsburg started an experimentum. And it was a successful experiment for 200 years without major conflicts inside of the region or between the different groups, cultural groups, confessional groups. You can believe it was a cohabitation, yes, between Catholics and Orthodox, between Christians and Jews. Yes, there are accepted a lot of different people with different languages. Romanians and Serbs as a basic population, but also a population which was colonized by the Habsburgs, like the Spanish population, in Zrenjanin, Nova Barcelona, New Barcelona. It was a colonist of Spain, soldiers which were colonized with families in the beginning of the 18th century. French people, Slovak people, Czech people, Italians, and much more, Swabians, German Swabians. That happened in the name of Catholicism, because the Habsburg Empire was Catholic Empire, but also in the name of experimentum, so-called experimentum, which resist until the beginning of the 20th century without great conflicts. Only the First World War started to divide the people very, of course, in 19th century, redefined the identity, cultural, political identity, but only in the 20th century started this this division. And we have another example in this these case, non-conflictual in general.
Yes.
Okay.
So, do you prefer the difference? Do you prefer to take? Just one question, or we'll make a round of questions in order to give the answer. So we'll respond to which question?
Alte aspecte, și conștiința din neam a avut un rol și apartenența confesională. Căci la români, până la urmă, cele două aspecte s-au apropiat atât de mult încât vor da expresia lege românească. Și asta cred că spune tot.
Da, iar la trece o pistolie colegă Naiman zašto toliko snažan upliv i uticaj ovog određenog perioda u istoriji Vlaške, u istoriji romskih zemalja, period Prvovjanova, upliv na Banat i koji su uzroci da je upravo u tom momentu toliko snažno to zračenje. I onda smo tjerno kažem da je to zbog nacionalnog osjećanja koji se izražava snažnije u tom periodu, već element za postupnice nacionalne štade. I sa druge strane je i pripadništvo što se tiče vere, dakle ista pravoslavna vera koja je sa obe strane Karpata prisutna. Potem să mai pun două, trei lucruri pentru colegii inițiale. Da, trage să-mi dați vorba, dar m-a luat puțin de comentar. Upravo, to je jako zanimljivo vreme, vreme prebiranja, to je period u vašoj istoriji poznat kao doba Bečkog rata i posledice. A Karlovački mir je tako i za Vojvodinu veoma značajno. Značajno je i za ovaj prostor ovde, istočni deo, da kažem tako, Banata i Erdelj. U tom periodu, vidite, imamo prisustvo Austrijanaca u Erdelju. Do Karlovačkog mira još je skoro 20 godina, 15 godina, ali Austrijanci su već ovde na terenu. I onda počinje to interesovanje, to buđenje tog hrišćanskog sveta iz ovog prostora i sa Balkana, ali i ovamo, severno od Dunava, i angažovanje na toj ideji, hrišćanskoj ideji, pokušavaju da privuku pažnju i Austrijanaca za njihove tegobe, za njihove nevolje, ali što se tiče Slovenaca i slovenskog sveta, interes i prema Rusiji. ca o protivteja određenoj opasnosti kod katoličenja. Već počinju ti problemi, a Konstantin Brkovjanov je veoma značajan kao ktitor tih crkava i manastira i tako dalje, na granici, na severnoj granici Vlaške prema Erdelju, kao protivteža budućem unijaču. Jako zanimljivo. I to je period i zona gde deluje pravoslavna reakcija prema unijačenju. Pomenuo bih samo putešestvije Visariona, Kaluđena Visariona u tom južnom delu Erdelja, i koji na kraju tog, da kažem, tog njegovog putešestvija u tim mestima, rumskim mestima rumskog Erdelja, svet koji u određenom momentu je prešao Uniji, se vraća u pravoslavlje. I još i sada sedište rumskog pravoslavlja je južni Erdelj, sa Sibivom i sa tu više crkava i veoma značajnih manastira, koje delom su zadužbine Konstantina Brkovjana.
Hvala. Thank you, Mio Drag. It was a very clear a short history of the period. So, Boris, the micro will be yours in order to respond.